Yeah. time.
You've been so good.
We're going to go strictly by the program. If there are any changes, I will come up and make the changes. As you see your name on the program, please come up and do what you have been asked to do. I will not come back up again until after the presentation of the Servant of the Year. So we will follow the program as printed. At this time, let us give a big amen for our opening prayer by Brother Edison Joyner.
It's about your grace and your mercy.
Yes.
feed us, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
And we want to say thank you.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Lord, your son Jesus, you went to the cross as your son Jesus. You could have come down.
Oh, my God.
But because of me.
Yes.
And because of everybody else that's around here right now. You stayed there. We thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Father.
Lord, you freed us from the devil. The devil has no place with us now.
My God, my God.
Heaven is our home. Because you freed us. Lord, all you ask us to do is to receive your son
as
our Lord and Savior. Lord, this gathering right here is evidence that we receive your son.
Yes,
Lord.
We thank you for him.
Thank you, Jesus.
Because this is all about him.
Yes, Lord.
And we thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
We thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Because you could have come down. But you said, Father, not my will. It wasn't because of you. It was because of me. He said, thy will be done. Because you love me so much, Lord. He said, let your will was to love me and to save me. And for that I said, thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
That you love me just that much.
Yes.
reason all the time just come before God. Because it's always His will, not our will. I'm so thankful just to be here this evening. God is so good. You know, for those of us who can, just stand, but I'm going to read the scripture from Psalms 27, 1 through 6. You know what I mean? It's just a good thing this evening.
For all of my life. I truly Benny, and everyone here basically is my extended family.
Yes.
Amen.
So the question is, when you hear "Welcome to the home of Adele and Benny," what exactly does that mean? It means welcome to a place where you can be vulnerable. It means welcome to a place where you can be comforted.
Yeah.
It means welcome to a place where your broken heart can be mended. Welcome to a place where you can be encouraged. Amen?
Amen.
And I could go on and on and on and on with many examples. But Hallelujah. Welcome to the home of Adele and Benny is synonymous with saying welcome to the house of the Lord.
Yes.
Amen? Welcome to the house of the Lord where your heart can be mended. Where you can be encouraged, where you can be comforted while you are vulnerable. Welcome to the house of the Lord. So we are in the house of the Lord. Amen?
Amen.
So we are to enter into his gates with what?
Yes.
Yeah. Enter his courts with what?
Praise.
Be thankful unto him and do what?
Praise.
Why will we do that? Because the Lord is what?
Good.
The Lord is what?
Good.
The Lord is good. Amen.
Thank you.
I tell it wherever I go.
Yeah.
I can't tell it there.
Hallelujah.
I should get my pastor's
The way the song goes, you do your part first, and then we'll talk to you. The way the song goes, you do your part first, and then we'll talk to you.
Oh, wait, I'll tell you what. I'll wait for you to be working somebody else.
altars coming together. Oh, I guess I have to go to church. The different altars coming together. A poor man cried in the church. I'm here to deliver me from all of my
issues.
Yeah. do deny. Hallelujah.
I can't go anywhere.
Hallelujah.
You remember the best place in the whole wide world is living in the Lord.
Yes.
If you're in God's will,
hallelujah,
you can never be saved. Yes.
For the word, for the word. Don't do it without it. Thank you, Lord.
Johnson, we
the members of Woven present you with a gift of $3,000.
Yes.
In this season, yes. In this hour.
you, no matter where you are, where your mindset is, to come close. Because the Lord is in his holy temple and he is speaking to his people. Don't let the enemy distract you in this beautiful home. We thank God that we're in such beautiful surroundings. But I come tonight to tell you that God has a word for his people. We want to start tonight by using a song to help us, to help you understand where we are. And give me one moment while I cue it up. But I want you to hear where God has spoken through the man of God for this season.
Sometimes there are obstacles in the road that can leave you feeling low, and you don't know how to move forward. And sometimes there are turns you want to take, but the way gets on the tracks. Now you're wondering, how did you get here? But don't you give up until you see how God is ordering your steps so you can walk into your seats. He that has begun a great work in you is faithful to perform. God is faithful to perform.
Yes,
he is. He that has begun a great work in you is faithful to perform. Our God is faithful.
Yes, he
is.
Faithful and great. is his faithfulness.
Yes.
So what should be considered as we proceed? Is that this work did not begin with you? Our mother's mother.
Get up and pray that you may not enter at all into temptation.
tonight we want to talk about, just for a few minutes of your time, why finishing your course is so important. Why finishing your course is, this is so, you know, we selected these topics a year ago. Dr. Johnson gave us the opportunity, each of us that she had invited to speak. She gave us an opportunity to go through the list of topics and to select a topic. And so a year ago, I selected this topic to speak on. I had no idea the journey that 2020 and 2021 would take me upon. But if I tell you God is a faithful and an awesome God, everything you're going through, nothing is wasted. It's for purpose, it is for His will, it is to get you where God wants you to be so God can use you in a mighty and awesome way. It doesn't feel good all the time. It doesn't look good all the time. Sometimes it looks really, 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 really bad.
Hallelujah.
It looks really, really dark. It looks really, really sad and hopeless. But He is our hope of glory. Here in this passage of Scripture, in verse 36, I had to wonder out loud. Jesus was asking, let me say this. I know we think the darkness that we see around us, this is the first time this has ever happened in the history of this world. But if you walk through the prophets, if you walk through the word of God, you will see that Hosea and some others, they talked about a season in life when men would not respect the things of God. When women would choose to live their life independent of God, when children would be raised by wolves, I call them wolves, godless people, who teach them the ways of the world instead of the ways of God. Who throw them out and tell them, you know, do your own thing because I'm living my life. These are not the first set of dark times that have come upon the face of the earth. And on this night, Jesus knew that some things were about to occur, that it was a dark time and that the real fight was right ahead of Him. He knew and He tried to prepare the disciples. What am I saying to you people of God? Some of you are in a real fight. In your minds, in your physical, in your trials, your tests, your issues of life. And if you're not careful, the devil will get the upper hand. He will try to tempt you into believing that God has forsaken you.
Hallelujah.
He's you. Oh, you don't have to testify. See, I know what I've been through. Jesus here is talking to His disciples, and He's telling them, you know what, whatever you got, you better get you a sword. Somebody's telling you, whatever you got, you better buy you a gun. But they don't believe the word of God will sustain you through this dark time, through this dark period. They want you to act just like the world. Oh, but God says, why are you sleeping?
Why?
This is not the time for the saints to be on break, to be lounging around. I know there are some hard situations in your life. I know there are some things that are going on that don't feel good, don't look good. The enemy, just like Job, he said, I'm walking to and fro. And sometimes, Brother Jesse, Pastor Jesse, he said, what about Jesse? I ain't volunteering to be Job either. But guess what? You don't have to volunteer. God says sometimes, have you considered my service? Sometimes God's building our muscles. God's building us up. God's preparing us to be able to do what is required of us. And sometimes it's in the valley low, that our muscles, our spiritual strength is really built up and honed up and prepared so that we can come against, do what God is called. God is calling us to a great work.
Hallelujah.
A great work. You can minimize what God has called you to if you choose to. But I'm here tonight to tell you, God is calling each of us.
Hallelujah.
A great work. Hallelujah. In verses 14 through 16 of that chapter, Jesus is telling His disciples that my time for real suffering is coming upon
us.
What I really came here to do is coming verse 42. Jesus prays, Father, if it be thy will, remove this cup.
Yes.
Now let me paint the picture for you. Jesus understood from being a little boy while he was here.
Yep.
He understood that his father had wrapped him in an earthly suit, a human body. The Son of God became the Son of Man so that the Son of Man could become the Son of God.
Amen.
Did y'all get that?
Amen.
The Son of God gave up his position and became, put on an earthly suit, and became the Son of Man so that the sons of men could become the sons of God rising in.
Hallelujah.
Nobody could do it but Jesus.
Jesus
was not confused about why he was here. Yet we find in the Word of God, in the Garden of Gethsemane, here was this awesome man of God.
Yeah.
This Son of God who God says, I am well pleased.
Yeah.
Right.
Who he had walked with God and been with God and been in the presence of God. What could he have known differently in that garden that it would give him such agony? That it would be such a burden.
Come on.
That he would sweat drops of blood.
Oh my God.
What could it have been? Because see, he knew that the sons of man, that there was no good in us.
Yeah.
He knew that we couldn't save ourselves and we were in need of a Savior. That's why the law was so prevalent. To help us understand we couldn't do it in our own strength.
Good word.
He knew that he was our only hope of glory. What in that moment had Jesus agonized to the point that he sweat drops of blood? That it bothered him that there was such an inner turmoil. We're talking about the great I Am, the Lord of Lords and the King of Kings. We're talking about the Son of God and the Son of Man who let Peter know, Peter, you don't have to fight for me because, see, my Father will send legions of angels to disrupt what these people are trying to do. We're talking about the Son of God who healed the sick and right. And my Bible says all that came to him, he healed. He cast out demons.
Yeah.
What is it that he could have been in such agony about? Because he knew why he was here. He knew what his purpose was. He knew why he had been born and why he had to die. Well, let me use my spiritual imagination.
Come on, girl.
In this moment.
By the way. Come on.
See, Jesus said to the disciples, why are you sleeping? In that 26th verse, he said, let me paraphrase, this is not the time to be asleep. He said, rise up, pray, that you enter not into temptation. I believe with all my heart that what Jesus was agonizing about was that he knew he had to be separated from the Father. The sweet intimacy that he knew of the Father, his friend, his daddy, he knew who his Father was. But see, when you're a child of God, there is a sweet intimacy that the enemy tries to disrupt. Because he knows when you're in the presence of God, somebody said tonight it is the most perfect place to be. Even when you're going through, even when you're walking, you know, in the darkness, even when you're climbing hills and it looks like you're never going to get there, when you have a sweet, sweet intimacy with God, can't nobody talk you out of it. Can't nobody convince you that he isn't a good God. Even when your money is short and your money is funny, your body is sick, can't know when you got an intimate relationship with God, when God is loving you, to have to give up in this moment was his sweet, sweet relationship. Because, see, he took on the whole world's sin. My Bible say past, present, and future. And we know what had light to do with darkness. We know that that fellowship, that relationship, that strong hope, it had to be broken for your sins and my own. Don't act like you've been wrong. Exposure.
Yeah.
It's expectation.
All right.
And it's endurance.
Yeah.
Exposure. Why finishing your course is so important? You gotta be exposed to the Word of God.
Amen.
You cannot be intimate with anybody in a relationship if you don't know who they are.
All along.
You cannot have confidence and faith and trust in anybody you haven't spent some time with. Some personal quality time. How do I get to know God? I get to know God through the living Word of God, through the Word that comes through my pastor's mouth, through others' mouth, through the Bible, reading the Bible, through the lyrics of biblical-based songs. That's how I get exposure to the Word of God. That's how I understand the promises. That's how I know what He's saying to me when He tells me I love you through the gospel.
Yeah.
When you read the gospel, see, the gospel is just a love letter.
Hallelujah.
About how God loved me so much. I know He loved you too, but it's personal to me.
Yeah.
Oh, God, you got to expose yourself to the love letters that He's written you, telling you how much He adores you, how
me.
Oh, I'm
me.
Word will not return home.
Yes.
So when God says right now. I don't care what's going on.
Yes.
What the enemy has tried to do.
Yes.
When there is an intimacy with God.
Oh, my God.
A trust, a reliance, a yes. confidence in him that only comes by being exposed to the word of God. I know a man of God who says, if I haven't won the fight, it's because I'm still in. My name is Victory.
Yes.
I win every fight.
Yes.
Because God promised me the victory.
Yes.
Whatever I'm going through, no matter how hard it is, no matter how tough it might look, Arthur, if I haven't won it, I'm still in the fight. So I gotta just keep fighting.
Yes.
I've gotta have an expectation that God is God enough to perform what he says.
Yes.
And he said he's my healer.
Right back in.
My hands in the Lord. Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Send
God in heaven.
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
Yep.
You gotta have some endurance.
Yes.
You gotta be firmly planted. What is endurance? Endurance is the fact, the power, and ability to withstand. To stand in difficult times. To, when it's problematic, circumstances don't line up to what we want them to be. When God has told us to go to school and we're looking around going, I ain't got no money to go to school. I don't want to get. And God is saying, go to school. God is saying, ministry. God is saying, speak life. But rather, we want to say some other things. Pastor been teaching about that unwholesome tongue. Mm-hmm. God, give us a wholesome tongue. Mm-hmm. Let us speak life.
Yes.
Like
yes.
That in yes. This circumstance. I'm running to a close.
Sorry.
How would God want us to have sweet intimacy? To be exposed to His word.
Huh.
To have an expectation that He is God.
Yes.
He is the great I am.
Yes.
The Lord of Lords. Why would God want us to have an expectation that whatever He's told us, whatever He's shown us in visions, signs, and wonders, whatever He's spoken into our lives, why would He want us to have a sweet, sweet confidence in Him?
Mm.
Why would God want us to endure to the very end?
Wow.
I come tonight to let you know that it's for His glory.
Yes.
It is all for God's glory.
Yes.
So that the whole world will see you, your
yes.
natural life that becomes supernatural,
yes.
will know that God hears and answers prayer.
Yes.
Why is it so important that you finish your course, that you keep going, that you don't fall? Do you know how many churches have closed their doors? How many pastors are saying they ain't preaching no more? How many missionaries are now doing other things? And I mean other things.
Amen.
Jesus said, why are you sleeping? This is not the time to sleep. It is so important, men and women of God, that we stand flat-footed, persevering, stand in our office, trust God that He's going to bring us through. The whole world is waiting. The whole world is counting on you. The whole world is looking at you, looking at the body of Christ, looking at the church, wondering where they won't make it, who will make it here? If they're giving up and waving the white flag to the enemy, who's going to stand for Christ?
Yeah.
I come tonight to let you know.
Yeah.
God is doing a
great
thing.
Yes, yes, yes.
To you.
Yes.
We are the only hand
that
God has.
Yes.
We're the only mouth that God has.
Yes.
We're the only feet that will take the word out into the highways and the byways. If we surrender to the enemy, if we give up, who's going to stand?
Hallelujah.
Who's going to let them know that He lives today? What the world needs is the Lord. What the world needs is more. Who's going to tell the story that a young virgin mother, a young girl who was betrothed to a young man, that she was found herself pregnant? She went to see her cousin Elizabeth, and Elizabeth said, when you gave the salutation, the baby leaped. Who's going to tell the story that through 42 generations, through the volume of the book, I was saved? Who's going to tell the story?
Yeah.
World. You know what the devil is coming? He's trying to literally devourer. He wants to tamper. He wants to fool them with all the foolish in the world.
Yes.
People of God, we got to stand in our heart.
Hallelujah.
We got to let the world
help.
No. Hallelujah.
Nobody but God.
Yes.
Nobody but God.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Why finishing your course is so important?
Yeah.
Because it's the Lord's doing.
Yes.
Everything about it
Hallelujah.
Is God's doing.
Hallelujah.
Every opportunity He gives us to bless Him is God's doing.
Yes.
Every opportunity to change your mind,
Hallelujah.
Change your life, it's God's
Hallelujah.
Doing.
Hallelujah.
Every opportunity
Hallelujah.
To stand before anybody, I'll tell a dying world, Jesus
is here.
Yes.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, my God. Oh, the Lord of God. That we find that when the saints, when the people of God came through.
Yeah.
When the Israelites came through the Red
yeah.
Sea, they collected memory stones.
Yes.
And they gave God glory.
Glory.
Miriam grabbed the tambourine, tambourine.
Oh, yeah.
And they start praising
oh, my God.
Oh,
what does God require? To do justice,
yes.
Love mercy,
yes.
To walk humbly
oh,
with God.
Yes.
That means you ought to have praise in your mouth
yes.
sometimes.
Yes.
You ought to have
yes.
a wave
yes. yes.
yes. You ought to have a wave offering in your
yes.
hands sometimes.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, he is.
works from the inside out.
Yeah.
Let me explain it to you.
Come on.
But Jesus got ready the last day of his life on earth. He was with his disciples like we are right now. They had dinner. And Jesus got up from the table, took off his dinner jacket like Tim have on now. And he got down, put a towel around him. Got down on his knees and started washing the disciples' feet. And then when he got through doing it, he asked him, he said, "Now, you don't know why I did that?" And of course they didn't know the answer. So what Jesus did was, he said, "Now I am Lord." In other words, he said, "I'm King of Kings and Lord of Lords."
Yeah.
I own everything.
Yeah.
But I washed the feet.
Hallelujah.
And he told the ministers, Timothy's one of us. And that's what Tim do all the time. Go out in the world and wash their feet. Be an influencer from the inside out. So you inside, you have the Holy Spirit in you.
That's right.
And it's nothing God but keep from you.
That's right.
Let me tell you about Tim. Tim don't look for no kind of attention. You wouldn't even know the things he do if I don't just stand here tonight and tell you. And Dr. Johnson have given me that privilege. Because he do stuff in private.
That's right.
Number one, Tim opens up the church every Tuesday night and closes it every Tuesday night.
Amen.
That means that he got to get the church an hour before everybody else. He got to turn on the microphones, make sure the air conditioning is fine, check the toilets, make sure everything is ready for Andre to come in to minister the word of God without any hindrance. When Bible study is over, Tim's going to stay there and he's going to close the church. He's going to make sure that Sister Mary Magdalene, the coffee pot, is unplugged. He's going to make sure there's no running water going on in the church. He's going to make sure everything is fine. So, you know, I would give him a little. The church don't have a lot of money, but we do have money. So I was writing him a check. In my spirit, I said, "Yeah, Tim, yeah, I'm going to give you this small amount of money." But Tim, I'm over the finance department, and I'm not computer literate like you are, but Tim didn't do all my data entry. He helped me do all the financial reports.
Wow.
He do so many things in the church. He pick up all the supplies. I used to do it then. But now I know I can pick up $32 of water and all the soda water and all this stuff that has to come to the church. So Timothy, you can trust him. He'll go and use his money, and then I just have to reimburse him. He do it all and don't try to get any attention for his money. Blessed is those who do it. Well, you want to know who is Timothy? Doing all this for God, who have God did for Timothy? Timothy started when he was 16 years old. He went to school to become an air conditioning technician. And he worked with me for how many years? About 10 years. He worked with me a long time. And all he knew how to do was it's window units.
Okay.
You know, window unit, you take it out the window, you know, and bring it to the shop because he really didn't know what he was doing. So his dad had to fix it and got to the shop. So Timothy started doing that. He had every meal here, and Neil would help him, and he used to have different people help him. So what happened was Timothy would help Jesse and help. Yes, he helped everybody. And you know, Tim just went for too much money. I think he got married at that time. But anyway, next thing I know, Tim has decided
and he's going to be a real academic technician. He went to back to school, passed that academician test. Now he's a licensed academician man. Own business, and Tim is so smart there. I'm telling you, he is so organized. If you tell Tim that you got to do an installation, that's his son back there, little Tim.
I love you,
Tim. Tim was sick the other day, and little Tim had to go and Henry put a card in yesterday. So little Timmy did come by the shop. I said, you know, I said, Tim, how you feeling? So I'm kind of tired now to put that card in. And that's what little Tim said, I'll put you back. I'm worried about it. Yeah. Yeah. The presence of God. When you do the word of God, you can't do the word of God. God has promoted Tim.
Thank you.
Certificate of appreciation from the Unified Women and Men of God, that's the one of the church, to Timothy Edwards and his senior, for all you do. For all you do to make our church one school. Most of them know all of you know
the
contributions that God does. And for this, we name you servant of the year. December
2018. Amen. Good word. Okay, before we sit down, Mama, I need you to come back up.
Spirit. And so I just got to tell you, man, I appreciate everything you do.
Sometimes I come to church early, he already there. I said I come to the church early, the gates is already open, everything already, he already, I know I can, if don't nobody be there but me and him, I know he's going to be there.
Right.
I mean, the faithfulness is just, yeah, you know, remarkable. And see, and I'm just going to throw this other little piece in. This jacket is not cheap.
Yeah.
And I noticed from the keyboard that the socks is much.
Yeah.
Now, everybody don't know that. He ain't going to tell you because he don't look out. But to take that jacket off and watch people feed it, it tells you what kind of man he is. And I'm going to leave it with that.
Thank you.
He knew I needed to hear you, and you gave us
the summer for completing Trinity Bible. We did not quit it, man. He gave us the E, the Z, when the teacher was out. Exposure, expectancy, endurance.
Amen.
He was endurance and he was still out.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
for we walk by faith.
That's it.
Not by sight.
My son, give me thy heart. Let thy eyes observe my ways.
Yeah.
somebody.
Yes, Lord.
Yeah.
Yes.
The one that I really love is in Ephesians 6, 10 through 17. Wherefore, on God, to the end of my letter, I tell you to be strong in the Lord and in his great power.
Amen.
Wear the full armor of God. Wear God's armor so that you can fight against the devil's clever tricks.
Yes.
Minister
gave me. to go out and buy. So I pray that you all enjoy the gifts and use them well.
Amen.
Jesse, you have been such a wonder. We want to thank you for all of these gifts. You just don't know how much your house shoes mean to me. I tell you, I wear out a pair of house shoes about once every 3 months, and I seem to have these supplies, and I always have an umbrella or house shoes. We really enjoy you and for what you do for us. We hope you take this gift and get yourself something nice that you have been wanting for a long time.
Thank you so much.
Around your love, how you spread it around and stuff, that you are so appreciated.
Thank
okay.
you.
Second gift. Is a gift of a love angel is to show you that throughout the year, you know, you have came into my life when I was about 13, and you don't really realize how much you was like an angel to me all through my young life and even up to now, that you are continued to like the angel that the Lord sent to me. Thank you very much.
Thank
Oh.
First Lady Velma Carrington.
Thank you.
Sister Patricia Joyner.
Thank you.
Sister Paula Covina Johnson. Donna McCardell Green.
Wow.
Okay.
Thank you.
not a member of the Unified Women of God.
Oh.
No, he's not a member.
Can you join me? I'm trying to help you too, though. When did you join?
Anytime.
Okay. Okay.
He just asked me to make time. Well, we've had a wonderful time tonight. And Denise, while you were speaking on, while we have finished our course, I was thinking about our record is going to be there.
Yeah. Yeah.
And you know, some of us don't come up to Christ, and we don't come up there trying to argue with Christ. You know what I mean? Yeah. Yeah. We're going to say, why are you not letting me in, and you just let him in?
Yeah.
I did this, and I did that. And Christ is just going to say, well, Angel, go get his book. Now the best book to find out how much you love God is your checkbook, Pastor. And that's all God's gonna need in the judgment. It's your checkbook. So he'll tell you, now give him his own checkbook and let him go to reading. He'd already be done figured out the totals. Las Vegas, $1 million. Baca, $330,000. Camel cigarettes, $2 million. Running women, $15,000. Running after somebody else's husband and trying to pay them, $20,000. Zero. Church offering. Zero. Money to the poor. Zero. And by the time that you get through reading all that to God, God is going to ask you a question. Now, do you see why you can't get into heaven? I'm not reading nothing but your checkbook. See, the Bible says where your treasure is, that's where your heart will be also. You can't tell me you love God and all your money is going everywhere but to the work of the Lord. And if you haven't been paying your tithe, you need to start paying.
Amen.
For him and his wife got a divorce. Five other people was trying to get the house. The lady that sold me the house said they couldn't get along. God just sent a spirit of confusion among them, and you are next in line. And I just you are, and your checkbook reads no tithes, no money to the church, nothing to the poor, but you just spent $1,000 in Las Vegas trying to win $200. Well, B, that's what I got from your message today. Why I have to finish my course. Because my record is going to be up there. And God going to look at my record and he going to say, you almost had it made.
But you didn't finish your course.
Finish.
Not only do we have to start it, but we got to finish the course. And I'm determined, Sister Betty, I'm finishing my course. I don't know what he's going to call me, but whatever he calls me, I'm going to be working on finishing my course. Because I want to see his face in peace. Oh my God, I bless God with this message. I bless God. Now, if you look in your gift, you will see a most beautiful CD by Paula. Paula made a CD. I just listened to it in my car. I listened to it here. And now we're going to sing a song from the CD, Jesus, Precious, Jesus, Oh, What a Wonderful Child. And then we're going to be in the hands of our illustrious pastor, Pastor Andre. Give Paula a hand. The last song, Jesus, What a Precious Thing.
Yes,
Well, let me get you to your bag to see if you have two CDs. That means somebody may get one.
Okay, is there somebody that did not get it?
Jesus,
and the word says,
Jesus,
for unto us,
Jesus,
Magnify you in the eyes of the people. And I also say that what she said tonight, what the Spirit of the Lord said through her tonight, it was a seed.
All right.
And the Bible said the Word of God is a seed.
Yes.
I'm not going to get into it tonight. Her revelation on intimacy is one of the greatest revelations that God has ever given to this woman.
Amen.
Yes.
If we can get to the place where we understand the magnitude of that revelation.
Amen.
Yes,
sir. We understood.
Yes.
Why Jesus agonized in the garden. Because he knew why he came.
Yes, sir. Uh-huh.
So he didn't agonize about going to the cross. He knew he came for that reason.
Yes.
But the revelation of was he would be momentarily separated from the Father because he had to carry our sins.
Hallelujah.
See, righteousness have no fellowship with unrighteousness.
Hallelujah.
And as long as he bore our sins, he could not have fellowship with the Father. That's why he cried in agony to the Father on the cross. Eli, Eli, Lama Sabachthani, why has thou forsaken me? You have to understand his relationship with God was a deeper intimacy than we will ever know. God said, who shall ascend unto the heel of the Lord? Anybody and everybody can't just go up there.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
He said, who shall stand in his holy place? Jesus said, the works that I do, it's my Father in me that's doing the work. He said, I speak not of myself, but the words that I speak. He said, the Father gave me the same. He said, me and my Father are one. And the only time in his existence that he had ever known separation from the Father he knew was on the cross. And the idea that he would be separated for a moment caused his sweat to drop like this. I'm not going to talk about that. God wants us all to have that kind of intimacy with him. God that we have experienced. I want to say to Shirley Burrell, I want to say to Viola Solomon, there is anointing that is upon your life. It is upon your life. God told me to tell you that tonight before I sit down. There is an anointing that is upon your life. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Come on, let's stand on our feet. We're ready to be this message. For you do all things well.
All things well.
We thank you, Father, for allowing us to be kind of worthy to be put into your ministry.
Yes.
Thank you for the set place you've given to us all.
Thank you, Jesus.
Help us to continue to love you and your people.
Yes.
And now, Father, we prepare to leave this place, but never your presence.
Yes.
We ask that you watch between me and these while we be absent one from another.
Yes.
In Jesus'
Jesus.
Mighty name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen.